Hello everyone. Firstly, I have a question for you guys. That's, are you guys ready? Okay. Hongling is reaching touring potential. This bike not only known for its many endowments, the title of victory is also famous for many traditional gong, including fucking in Jungle Wood. Hi everyone, my name is Nguyet. I'm 12 years old. I'm a student at Chungleung Secondary School. Hongling is reaching touring potential. This bike not only known for its many endowments, the title of victory is also famous for many traditional gong, including fucking in Chungleung Wood. From Hating City on Highway 1A, about 35 km north, visit the Forge of Villas at base on Hongling Mountain, Shabada by Wading Lasang Dai and a gentle poetic Ming River. Chungleung Villas is famous for traditional fogging that's minted and developed for many years. It's one of many traditional fogs that still exist today because of the high value village product. The history of the traditional fogging of Chungleung. Although no one had quickly the identified perfection of Chungleung ever, even the Wilsonia, they only know that from the bird to wing up have been a check to the image of Smithy. Many evidence say that this profession dates back to the dynasty, right from the time of the village. There's also another explanation about the formation of the village through folk tales. The story goes that in the old days, there were two blacksmiths came here to start a career, Chung Yu-chung and Chung Yin. Shortly after his brother, Chung Yu-chung stayed in part of the career to the people of Chungleung village, the younger brother went to Asian Kapia Pue to establish the village of Hien Luong. In return for the great merit of the person who taught the profession in Chungleung village. So in Chungleung temple in 1880, there were two poems about them. There's another legend about the blacksmith named Mitadung. He lived on Hongling Mountain. Five people did not have rubber too. Production activity has many difficult. So they drag up iron and pluck it for a tree, burning to coal for rubber too for a home. Many people in giant fire to apply for apprenticeship and be passed it down by him. Later, the villagers remember the merit of the blacksmiths, so they cut the temple in Rutian, located right in the village, and call it the Chalk of Holy Worker. Although there are many different interpretations of the origin of the four professions in the process of birth, existence, and development to stay, forging in general and traditional, forging in Chungleung in particular, have contributed greatly to construction and protection of the country. During the Confirmed Perpetual, the literature of the winter to swing hit for death 1,000 cold, night, sword and firearm, serving resistance every night, 3 to 4 a.m. heard the sound of iron hammering coming from small neighbor households. Today, in the face of fierce competition from the market economy, the fogging of Chungleung village is still constantly evolving. Currently in the world, there are 104 households, 9 Michelin composting houses, and 14 facilities, many facilities in the village craft subgroup. Products of the village for many households are playing like survive, knife, scissors, sickle, hoe, plowshare, hard or plate. There are also a number of nutrients that the product of processes still remaining of day. As a result, the menu from Chungleung village is more diverse. That contribute to preserving the long tradition of fogging Chungleung ever, and I think it's very lovely to our days. And remind me of the impressiveness of visitors when they have the opportunity to return for Chungleung for loving land and still people in all areas of living. The fogging profession of Chungleung ever from before. Now and later, we will still up with people with answering them love, perhaps in the eye. The traditional forest will has now been one by one. This like noble beauty, worthy of being treasured and keep until tomorrow. In a short span of time, but you and I have been learning some useful information about the formation of Chungleung village. Hope to meet you in this beloved land and be ready to serve you when you need to your handmade product of the fogging profession in my country. Thank you for watching and listening.
Chúc mừng cháu đã thực hiện xong cái phần thi của mình. Phần thi của cháu phải nói khá là hoàn mỹ. Cháu thuyết minh rất là tự tin, rất là duyên dáng. Chú chỉ hỏi cháu một câu ngắn thôi. Ở Trung Lương ta thì ngoài nghề rèn truyền thống ra, chúng ta còn có nghề gì truyền thống nữa không? Trong clip của cháu là có xuất hiện cả cái nghề này đấy. Chú đưa ra một gợi ý nhỏ, đó là nghề này cũng là nghề sản xuất ra nông cụ, chế tác ra nông cụ sản xuất.
Lời đầu tiên cho em xin phép cảm ơn quý ban giám khảo đã đặt ra câu hỏi cho em. Và em nghĩ câu trả lời mà ban giám khảo tìm chính là nghề rèn, chính là nghề nghề đúc cắt ở phường Trung Lương ta đây. Nó là một cái truyền thống rất lâu đời của ta. Và đó là câu trả lời của em. Kính mong ban giám khảo có lời nhận xét thêm. Và lời cuối cùng cho em xin phép được nói là cảm ơn sân khấu Hồng Linh trong trái tim em đã cho em phép cơ hội được tỏa sáng ở tại đây ạ. Em xin cảm ơn tất cả mọi người ạ.
Vâng. Xin chúc mừng câu trả lời của em. Câu trả lời chính xác được hơn 90%.
Tại sao? Cảm ơn ban giám khảo ạ.
Vâng, đó là nghề đúc gang, không phải là đúc sắt truyền thống. Nghề ta chỉ cần nói nghề đúc truyền thống là được. Đúc gang nó có, nghề truyền thống này nó có 6 nghề rèn. Nhưng mà Trung Lương là một cái vùng địa phương tuyệt vời, nơi lưu giữ được cái hồn cốt quê hương không nói, chứ mà vẫn lưu giữ được cái nghề nghiệp của mình, nuôi sống bản thân những người thợ. Và từ cái nghề đúc truyền thống này thì thời xưa ấy, là người nông dân ta đi cày thì phải có cái lưỡi cày, cái diệp cày bằng gang. Và bây giờ thì họ chuyển sang đúc các cái thiết bị máy móc. Và chúng ta đang thấy nhiều cái lò đúc ở trong khu cụm công nghiệp làng nghề Trung Lương. Xin chúc mừng cháu.